crew. Started off as one time only. Now you be rolling up every morning. You know who to hit up when you lonely. You know who to hit up when you horny. I can't lie, be caught in the moment. A woman alive like I don't enjoy it. Tryna pull up with all of my homies. If foreign the warns, my engines are roaring. Know some rappers pretending they real, but really they out here aluminum falling. Gotta make sure I handle my biz. Don't wanna be worried about constantly touring. I can see that you copying, but I keep giving it. I ain't wondering why. Gotta make sure that all of my kids forever be straight whenever I die. I be sipping on holy water. Pain only pushed me farther. Thought that you'll believe in Jesus. Why you smell like marijuana? Better than a pastor daughter. Never once said I was flawless. I am just a soul survivor. You an internet explorer. This is not a children's story. Really wish I could say more. Man told me keep it honest. Trauma tells me to avoid. God told me to change the topic. Flesh told me to raise the score. You can never satisfy it. It keeps on wanting more and more. Keeps me waking up at four. Even when my body's sore. Keeps me on my toes. Finding windows when it starts slamming doors. And it's keeping me thinking that I am not good enough. If I don't bother and cop a chain, and it keep me from loving the way that she won't. I be licking like shut up and give me brain. They gon' pay me as long as I entertain. I ain't tripping off nothing, I got a game plan. I seen you stepping in, boy, you can't dance. Soon as it gets hard, you change plans. I seen a guest star get fame fast, then start driving like the cane crash. We throwing cash while she rain dance. Why does the pain last? We don't ask anybody. Head day, I gotta fight it. I got some really good news that didn't affect my mood, not in the slightest. They think I'm playing it cool, but I am not. I just don't get excited. I got whatever I need, but feel like I lose if I'm not getting higher. I need somebody to watch my body. With holy water, hang on and push me farther. Thought that you'll believe in Jesus. Why you smell like marijuana? Better than a pastor daughter. Never once said I was flawless. I am just a soul survivor. You an internet explorer. This is not a children's story. Really wish I could say more. Man told me keep it honest. Trauma tells me to avoid. God told me to change the topic. Flesh told me to raise a score. You can never satisfy it. It keeps on wanting more and more.
I lost count of all these blessings, yeah.
I cannot count them all, yeah. I cannot count.
yeah. Them all, yeah. I cannot keep them all.
When God doing ain't no stressing, hell.
They came with no sorrow, yeah. They came with no sorrow, yeah. They came with no sorrow.
I'm grinding still.
Yeah, what? What a stench. Devil trying to come and steal my joy. Like the Grinch. Crazy when I'm jolly, jolly. They gon' take offense. It ain't pagan. Let you make it. You ain't even making sense. July time cruise. Can you be for real? All my demons look depressed. It ain't no big deal. Look, I'm breathing underwater. I ain't got no gills. Holy Spirit, superpower. Like the man is still.
Me and Trey done got the Holy Spirit like we match. I'm scared of death if when I die, I get a mensch. I can see the future be with Jesus, diamond dance. Hopped in the word, it's like a light, that's how I'm standing.
Camera out my face, we ain't posing, take on candy. Ain't nobody scamming. I pray to the Lord, so I'm getting understanding. When he moved that stone, rock, hell, holy bandage. So now we take the flesh away from soul and leave it stranded.
Don't care how you feel. I need peace of mind before I touch a meal. Need to be like me, oh my God, he took the bill. I done thrashed a couple times, I'm grinding still. With the three just like I'm Chance. In the ring ain't switching stance. I don't do the mistletoe. Jesse can't even get a glance. She must think it's Hallmark. Rack still on my wifey hand. Devil crew on Paul Block. We deep out the caravan. Never ducking smoke with principality. Still move like the 12, feel like I'm fresh out the academy. Know my new anatomy, I guess that's why they mad at me. We straight through the storm, the devil camp is looking static.
I was stuck in death, cut that messing with Medusa. Crazy from a manger to the cross and never blew it. Must be in the tether, ain't no hezzy, he just do it. Took me as a wreck, now I ain't heavy, hallelujah.
Gather around the fireplace, God he took my burdens on. Always knew my God is giving, never knew no Santa Claus. Tell the world stop playing with me, doing what my God involved. Way too many gifts I got this year, I can't even count them all.
Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, are you ready?
Good morning, good morning, good morning, crossover. Time to get up on your feet. Come on, it's time to praise the Lord. Get your hearts, minds, and soul ready to give praise unto Jesus. Hallelujah! Put your hands together for the Lord right now! Hallelujah!
Everybody clap your hands!
Lord, I fully commit as the blessings fall down. Lord, I receive it. Hey!
Hands up.
take your place. Jesus, take your place. Say it again. Let all the other names
fade away.
Hallelujah. Let all the other names.
Let all the other names fade away.
Say it on.
Hands in the air as we give God praise and say thank you for who he is. God is a healer. take it to God and say, I believe that you are all that I need.
How many of y'all know that nothing is impossible for God? We've been baptizing people and we've been singing this last song like nothing's impossible for God. How many of y'all believe he's our healer? So this is my brother Brian, Brian Chavez, and I didn't even know what the last song was today, but look at how the Holy Spirit lines it up. We sang, God is my healer. Nothing's impossible. But this guy's story, 10 years ago, he was on his deathbed with multiple tumors. But God has been his healer. And and nothing's been impossible. He couldn't even walk. He couldn't even talk. He couldn't use the left side of his body. It took him some time to go through rehab and some years to fully, like, recover. But he's back to 110% now. And so he hit me up. He's like, man, I got to do this. I got to be all in for God. And so today, we're excited to baptize each and every person that we baptize, but there's a story behind every single person. And Brian's story is, man, God has healed him. God has things for him to do. God has things for you to do. Nothing's impossible. And so today, Brian, because of the relationship you have with Jesus, we celebrate that in front of your Crossover family, and we baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Crossover family, if you pray with me, Father, we come before you today. We thank you for new life, new spiritual life. We thank you for all these people that have gotten baptized during this service today as they're making a public proclamation to say, I'm now following Jesus. I'm serving Jesus. So God, we thank you that you're moving in this house. You're moving in people's lives. People are making commitments and they're following you, God, with all their heart, their soul, their mind, and their strength. And God, we declare today, we believe that nothing is impossible with you. You can be a healer. You can do miracles. You can heal us physically, mentally, emotionally, in every different area, God. So God, we thank you. It's no accident or coincidence that each person is here today to be part of this worship experience, God. We pray that you'll move during the rest of our time together today. We pray this in Jesus' name. Everyone said, amen. Come on, make some noise for God today. Hey, before you're seated, guys, if you could say what's up to at least like 10 people, say welcome to Crossover.
Can we go ahead and just again clap our hands and let's celebrate all the folks that we got that just got back. Come on, y'all. We did a baptism just now. Somebody else ought to be excited to celebrate other people who are making progress in their lives. Yeah. What a blessing. What a blessing. What a blessing. Oftentimes, what you take for granted, other people are praying for. Let me say that again. What you take for granted, oftentimes, other people are praying for. Last year at our church, we baptized several hundred people. And if we're not careful, we could almost take that for granted as though that's normal. There's some churches that the last several years, they haven't baptized anybody. Can we clap our hands again for what God is doing in the life of our church? God, we're grateful for it. God, we're thankful for it. There's a verse that my children learned when they were in elementary school at the school that they attended. And it's Psalm 18 and 30. And I remember it because I had to help them memorize it. And it was a verse that they quoted every single day before school started. It was a part of their morning litany. It's Psalm 18 and 30. It's a good verse for you to think about or maybe go at some point in reference as well. And it's really simple. And the verse says, Psalm 18 and 30, it says, as for God, his way is perfect. As for God, his way is perfect. As for God, his way is perfect. I'm a Christian because when I look at the Bible and I look at what God says, his way has been perfect. I don't see a point where God misses. He doesn't miss. Do me a favor, look at the person sitting next to you and say, God doesn't miss. Whether it's relational advice that God is offering, God doesn't miss. If I follow his advice, God doesn't miss. If I follow, as you're going to see today, we're talking about health today. As I follow God's health plan, God doesn't miss. In terms of my mental health, when I follow God's plan, God doesn't miss. When I think about interactions at work, how I do my work, God doesn't miss. And so it's the same thing in terms of my finances. Everybody say money. When I follow God's plan, even for my money, God doesn't miss. And so there's oftentimes, y'all, that we're in situations with regards to our monies and our finances because it means a lot to us that we've gotten ourselves in where we have to pray and ask God to bail us out of that. How many of y'all have ever been in a situation you needed God to bail you out of something, right? And so our commitment as a church, our challenge to you as a church is to challenge you in every single area of your life. See where you can get in alignment with God's plan. Because as for God, his way is perfect. God doesn't miss. And so when we stand before you every single Sunday to remind you to give to God, that's what it is. It's a reminder. We can't force you to do it. We can't manipulate you into doing it. We're not going to manipulate anybody to do it. We're not going to strong arm anybody to do it. We're not going to guilt you into do it. We ain't going to try to play hype music to try to make you emotional to give. We want you to make an intentional decision. Somebody say intentional. We want you to make an intentional decision, not just with the 10% of what you bring to God, but the full 90% of how you honor God with that as well. Because you can bring your tithe to God, the 10%, but if you don't honor God and how you spend the 90%, you're still going to have some challenges. As for God, his way is perfect. And so God gives us instructions about how to do that and what to do that and how to walk in wisdom. He invites husbands and wives to be on the same page and to walk in agreement with one another. How can two walk together unless they agree? So the Bible says, he challenges us to be humble, to not be entitled with the resources that we have. He causes us and challenges us to remember that every resource we have belongs to him in the first place. That he blesses us to be a manager, the Bible says, a steward over those resources. And I know that many of you all come from various backgrounds and churches with all kinds of other baggage about how churches navigate this and handle this. But as you get steeped into Crossover's rhythm and our tradition here, you're going to find that we just want you to make an intentional, logical decision that as for God, even with my money, his way is perfect. If you got that, just raise your hand back at me. Just raise your hand back at me. Amen. They're going to put on the screens how we give every single week. I want to take a quick moment as they put those up. I'm going to invite Andrew and Dee to come up really, really fast. They are our new leaders of Fire Starters. Come on, y'all, give it up for them. Yep. God sent them here from the Baltimore area. They are grieving a little bit now because the Ravens lost, but God's still a healer. Amen. But we're thankful for Andrew and thankful for Dee. They are going to be our primary leaders and touch points for Fire Starters, all things Fire Starters. And I want to challenge every single one of you. If you've not yet taken that step, Fire Starters is a big deal here because it puts on automatic what we say is a priority. That if God is actually a priority in our lives, we put our giving on automatic. Those of you that want to do at least $20 per week, automatic giving, where it comes out every single week at the same time, in the same manner, you can sign up for Fire Starters. We got Fire Starters boxes out there. I didn't bring one out on stage with me. I missed that, so I apologize for that. But there's all kinds of resources in that box that you can take with you. Is that the box? Thank you, Vincent White. Not Vanna, but Vincent. So this is a sample of the Fire Starters box that you get. We do a quarterly gathering with Fire Starters. These individuals, Andrew and Dee, are going to be touching bases with you on a regular basis, making sure that you're also supported, prayed for, cared for, if you're a Fire Starter. So we want to lovingly challenge and invite those of you that are really intentional about being all in with your giving, with your tithe. We've got the tithe challenge that's going on right now. That's on our website as well. And so I want to invite you, jump in today. And if you got more questions, they will be outside in the lobby after this service is over with to answer those questions. And if you sign up today, you'll also be able to take your box home with you today, all right? If you got it, say, I got it. All right. Thank you. Appreciate y'all. Andrew's like, get me off of this stage. Amen. Oh, be careful. Amen. You're going to get ready to catch him too, Cross. I appreciate that. Let's pray together, y'all. Father, we love you. We thank you. Thank you for the provisions that we do have. I pray right now blessings on every single gift and every single giver at our church. And I pray very regularly, God, for those that are part of our church and desire to give but don't have the resources to give. I pray, God, that you would put them in a space and a place where they will have those resources at some point in time to be able to honor you with what you've blessed them with. I've not prayed a prayer like this before, God, but I pray very boldly this morning that if there's somebody under the sound of my voice, whether in this building or online, that has a stingy spirit, where they have been walking in complete error and disobedience with you, I pray that they don't reap what they've not sown. Father, I pray that their stinginess, that they will become uncomfortable with it. There's somebody that you've blessed with incredible resource that they refuse to let go of. It has become an idol in their life. I pray that, God, that they will honor the conviction that they feel and sense today. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, clap your hands, everybody. I just got to pray it as I sense it. I just have to pray it as I sense it. Amen. Y'all, listen, we're starting a brand new series today. It's going to be amazing. I can't wait for y'all to hear this sermon series that we're starting today. So go ahead and turn your attention to the screens. Let's get ready for God's word today.
Fitness and getting in shape can be fun. It doesn't have to hurt, and it doesn't have to be weird. We've talked about mental and emotional health. We've talked about financial health. We've even covered relational health. It's time to cover physical health. We want our bodies to be healthy, healed, and whole. We want to be fit. Join us on this journey to becoming a church that's fit. We'll be a fit church. We're going to shed pounds, take steps, get educated and informed, and fulfill God's promise for our lives. Welcome to A Fit Church and the Fit Church Initiative. We're going to help you thrive and not fail.
What's up, Crossover? How y'all feeling? Y'all ready today for Fit Church? Looks a little small. Well, that's because this jacket is my jacket from middle school, my favorite jacket. I was taking you all the way back to the late 80s, right? So sometimes we have a fit that it doesn't fit anymore, right? And so, but then there's other times when we'll put another jacket on, and actually I helped design this jacket right here. This is one of my eternal jackets. And you could go from something that's too small to you could do something like this too, though. You know, I know baggy's coming back in, but I'm like totally like swimming in this jacket, right? So let me try. Hold on, let me try this one on here. What size is this one? That was a 3X. Okay, this is a large. So this should be, yeah, there we go, just right. All right. So we want to help you this year find what your perfect fit is, because some of us, we have outgrown some stuff. Some of us, we need to maybe downsize on. Some of us, it's just not the right fit. 2024, our theme at Crossover Church is help us out. It's rebrand 2.0. We want to help you be spiritually fit, but we want to help you guys be physically fit as well. And a lot of churches don't talk about the physical part. They miss that part. But we know that your spiritual calling is directly connected to your physical health. Those things are connected. They are intertwined. And if you are having physical issues, you're not going to have the full capacity to do everything God has called you to do. How many of y'all know that? So we're going to rebrand ourselves and become a fit church. I'm going to share some stuff today that I've never shared before publicly at a service. I've always been healthy. I never really got sick much. Still don't get sick very often at all, thank God. But in 2011, I was under a lot of extreme stress. We had just recently moved into this building. There was lots of new people coming. It was a lot of new dynamics. Some people were leaving the church because they couldn't take the big environment. They liked the little small building we were in before. But yet there was hundreds of new people, and it was a lot. On top of that, when we came in here, we had to build everything out. And so we had a lot of financial debt from the construction, and we had some pressure, and there was just a lot going on. So I was stressed in some different ways. And I started noticing that I was waking up in the middle of the night. And sometimes, you know, you wake up in the middle of the night and you're stressed out, you're thinking about stuff, you can't fall back asleep, right? Well, I went to the bathroom one night and laid back down in bed, and suddenly, like, my heart started racing. I just thought it was maybe stress, or maybe I'm having one of those things. What are those, panic attacks or something? I never had one of those before. But my heart's beating, and I started sweating. And so I got up, and I went back to the bathroom, and I'm like, man, am I sick? Did I eat something funny? But my stomach didn't hurt. You know, so it was like weird. I never felt this before. And so I go out to the living room and I open up my computer and I'm Googling at 3 a.m. my symptoms, right? I'm like, what is going on with me? Do I have like low blood sugar or something? I'm shaking a little bit and I'm just like, man. And so I went and got some orange juice because orange juice can solve anything, right? It's healthy. So I got some orange juice and I was sitting there and I was just trying to calm myself down. I'm breathing. And within 15 minutes, like it just passed. It was gone. I'm like, okay, cool, I'm gonna go back to bed. Went back to bed, fell right asleep, woke up the next day. I felt fine. I'm like, that was weird. Huh, maybe I just ate something. It was this weird freak thing or whatever. Didn't happen again, but then another month later, it happened again. And then a couple weeks later, it happened again. And I'm just trying to like ignore it. Like, it's gonna go away. I'm gonna, you know, do this or that. And then it happened 3 nights in a row. And then the last night it happened, like I didn't go back to sleep. The orange juice wasn't working that night. Like I was up for hours and I never fell back asleep and I was just exhausted. And my wife was telling me, like, you need to get checked out. And I called my mentor. I'm like, what do I do? You know, I was like, you need to listen to your wife. You need to go to the doctor today. But see, here's the thing. I didn't have a doctor. I've been in Florida over 15 years and I was scared to get my blood taken. I'll tell you, I'll admit it right in front of everybody. I still don't like it, but I do it. I can do it now. But I was just so terrified to get my blood taken. I'm healthy. I never get sick. I'm like, well, man, I don't need no doctor. You know how sometimes what knucklehead guys are, right? I was one of those guys, right? And so I'm like, all right, well, I don't even have a doctor. So my wife called her doctor and got me in at her doctor's. And, you know, I got blood work and I almost passed out. And, you know, I'm good now. And I got the results back a couple days later that I was having issues with my thyroid. Never even really knew what a thyroid was. I heard about it. I didn't know what it did. I never had any issues with it, right? So I was having some issues with my thyroid. And so, you know, they gave me some medicine for it. And they said, here, take this. And, you know, so I started taking it. And I started to feel a little bit better. But I still didn't feel normal. And I'm like, nah, man, I'm not going to, like, live like this the rest of my life. I got to figure this out. And so another friend of mine told me about this doctor that specializes in thyroid issues, and she does holistic medicine. So I went to her. She did a complete blood panel, looked at all the different levels inside of my blood, and did all these other tests on me, and she put me on several different natural supplements. I had to change a little bit of things with my diet and all these things to get me in balance. And I discovered that I had some issues with gluten. I had some issues with processing folic acid, which that is sprayed on everything that is like bread, rice, wheat, grains, all that stuff. That's what they do in our country. They spray it on everything, and it says enriched or fortified. But as much as like 40, 45% of the population now has what I have, where we can't process it properly, and over time, you begin to have some different issues, hormonal issues eventually, and it can like really impact and affect you if you don't know what's going on. And they don't always diagnose it properly. And so around that time as well, I met my man Tony. And so me and Tony, he started taking me to the gym. I was like working out more regularly, right? I changed some things in my diet. I started taking some of these natural supplements. And you know what? A couple of months later, I not only felt back to normal, but I felt better than ever because I made some changes. So I had to get a vision for my physical health, y'all, and I had to stick to it. It's one thing to have a vision, but it's another thing to actually stick to it. And people ask me all the time, like, man, I can't believe you're 50 years old. What are you doing? I got a plan. I got a vision for my health. There's some things I'm intentionally doing that I'm about. So if you're here today in this room or in your room streaming this right now, whether you're 22, 32, 42, 62, 82, whatever your age is, listen, I'm here to tell you, like, you need a plan. No matter how good or how bad your health is, and even if your health is really bad right now, I'm telling you, with God's help, you could turn it around. You could turn 2024 could be your year to rebrand and get healthier. And if you're here today and your health is pretty good, guess what? You could get better. We could get even better together, and that's what we're going to do in this year. How many of y'all are with me? How many of y'all are ready to rebrand our health, to be a fit church? That's what we're going to do. So if you're with me, stand up with me. Stand up with me. We're going to read an opening passage of Scripture today. This is found in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, starting in verse 19. And the Bible says this. It says, don't you realize that your body is the what of the Holy Spirit? It's the temple who lives in you and was given to you by who?
God.
Your body is given to you by God, right? You do not belong to yourself, for God bought you with a high price. So you must what?
Honor
God with your body. Let's pray. Let's talk to God. Heavenly Father, we come before you today. God, we ask that you'll forgive us for the times that we don't honor you with our bodies, for the times that we're not taking care of ourselves, we're not resting properly, we're not eating properly, we're doing things that we shouldn't be doing to our bodies. God, I pray today that you'll convict every single one of us. None of us are better than the other. No matter what our shape is in here, God, we all need to work on this and we can all do better. There's so many temptations and distractions out there to get us to not take care of our bodies in the proper way. But I pray that today will be a turning point, a catalyst for all of us as a church family to become more fit physically, God, so we can have the full capacity to do everything that you've called us to do and that we can be at our best. And so, God, we want to honor you today. We want to honor you with our bodies, and we declare that. We pray this in Jesus' name. Everybody said,
amen.
Amen. Give somebody a fist bump and tell them, honor God with your body. If you're worshiping online at home, type that in the chat. Honor God with your body. Everybody say what's up to the online family. Make some noise for them. Thank you guys for tapping in with us. Every week we have hundreds and hundreds of people from all over the place that worship with us online. And so type in the comments where you guys are tapping in from today. So honor God with our bodies. What is one way we can honor God with our bodies? We can have a vision. Somebody say vision. We got to have a vision for our physical health. And so I want to break down this passage a little bit deeper from Corinthians. And if you read the context before verses 19 and 20, which I just read, it talks about sexual immorality. It talks about sexual sin. So Paul is the writer, and he's writing this to the church in Corinth. And the Corinthians, they were wild. They were wilding out. There was some crazy sexual stuff that was going on. And so he was like putting them in their place. He's like, listen, like sexual immorality, sleeping around with everybody, it's a sin against your own body. And he tells them that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, God's Spirit, right? So why is that so significant? Well, if you know biblical history, like the temple was a big, big deal. See, as a matter of fact, like the Israelites didn't even get to have a temple for a long time because remember when they were in the wilderness, they were in slavery, then they were in the wilderness, then they were, you know, trying to, you know, get established and all that stuff. So they met in tabernacles for a while. It was basically like a church in a tent. They were having tent revivals, Pastor Christopher, like every day, right? That's what they did. They had a tabernacle. But eventually they were able to have like a legit temple that was built. And it was actually King Solomon was the one that built the first temple to God in the Old Testament, in 1 Kings chapter 3, verse 1. And so in the Old Testament, there is a lot of details about what was supposed to be inside of the temple, like all the different pieces and furniture and the dimensions and the sizes. I mean, it was that way with the tabernacle as well. God was very detailed to say, this is what my holy temple is going to be like. And so they worshiped there. They came in God's presence there, right? They brought the request to God there. It was a holy place. Somebody say holy. So the temple was like a really big deal. There was actually a section in the back of the temple that was called the Holy of Holies. And nobody was allowed to go in there except the high priest. And because of God's presence in there was so thick. And they would actually sometimes even put like a rope around them. Like if he went in there and he wasn't right before God, like he could die in God's presence and they would have to like pull him out with the rope. I mean, it like God's presence was in that temple. That's if people wanted to go meet God and bring their sacrifices and pray, they had to go to that specific place. So here's the significance of it, y'all. If you're taking notes today, write this down in your notes. Type this in your crossover app, right? When Jesus came, he eliminated the need for a temple being in a single location. Jesus changed everything, y'all. Meaning like the temple would be the only place you could go to experience God's presence. Jesus changed all that. Talks about it in Matthew chapter 27, verse 51. That's when Jesus was on the cross. And when he said, it is finished. And the Bible tells us, and history, many historical writings talk about that this happened as well outside of the Bible. Extra biblical stuff says, yeah, there was this earthquake when Jesus died. And it says what happened in the temple, the Holy of Holies, that area in the back of the temple, like there was a curtain to get into the Holy of Holies. That veil, that curtain was ripped from top to bottom. And what that did is that represented like God's holiness, his presence now is available to you. You don't have to go to a building. You don't have to go through a mediator. Jesus was the final mediator that came for you and for me. And now we can be in his presence and we can experience that at any time. So Jesus, he changed everything, because the sacrifice he made for us, we're now clean and pure enough that God's Spirit can live in us and we can have a meeting place between heaven and earth right here at any time. We can commune with God and we can talk to other people, and other people can get in God's presence with us, right? So as believers in Jesus, as Christians, if you have a relationship with Jesus, God's Spirit is in you, right? Now, like, Paul's reminding him and say, hey, you shouldn't defile your body and do things that are sinful. You shouldn't defile your body by things that you put in your body as well, right? So Christians, we shouldn't engage just in sexual sin, right? We should honor our body in every way. It goes beyond just what we do sexually. It also includes how we take care of this body, this temple, because you only get one. You only get one body. That's it. I don't know, they got all kinds of little things in health now, like you can get a new kidney or you can get a new part or whatever, but at the end of the day, you still, like, you only get one body. Write this down. This is key for us to really get a vision for our bodies to honor God. You do not belong to yourself. You do not belong to yourself. Let me say that one more time for the people in the back. You do not belong to yourself. You don't. That's what the Bible tells us, and we believe what the Bible says, right? But I know that's a little tough for us to hear, because we live in this individualistic, do-it-yourself, pull-yourself-up-by-your-bootstraps, entrepreneurial, self-made man, boss, lady, woman culture, right? That's the world we in, and we love, we vibe, we thrive off of that kind of stuff, right? But if you're a follower of Jesus, it says you don't belong to yourself. God bought you with a high price. He gave his only son, Jesus, to come down and die on a cross for your dirt, for my dirt, for our drama. You don't belong to yourself. God redeemed you. He's got a plan for you. He's got a purpose for you. So you got to take care of yourself. You got to honor God with your body. Honor God with your body. Because our bodies don't belong to us. They're a gift, right? So now that we've established that, we got to take the very best care of our bodies. We got to honor God. Last week, we talked about how Jesus was talking to some religious leaders, and like usual, they were always trying to put him on blast and make him look bad. And so they were trying to trip him up, and they're like, Jesus, hey, what is the most important commandment? And he responded back in the Gospel of Mark, chapter 12, verse 30, and he replied, and he said, you must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind, and all your what? What's that last part? Your what? Strength. Say it one more time. Strength. Your strength. I want to ask you today, how is your strength? Back in 2011, my strength wasn't that great. I was tired. I was exhausted. I was stressed out. Be honest with you, I was eating a lot of fast food. I wasn't exercising as much as I should have. I was letting stuff get to me. I was just, man, like it was, anybody can relate to that? Go through seasons like that? You're like, man, I don't feel like doing nothing. I get home, I just want to lay on the couch, be a vegetable, right? And just watch TV or just stare aimlessly and scroll on my screen, right? So easy to do that, right? Now, some of you could try to love God with all your heart, soul, and mind, but because you're weak right now, physically in some ways, Like, you can't really follow through with that like you could if you had strength. Somebody say strength.
Strength.
Right? So, listen, I'm not trying to offend anybody today. I love all y'all. I want to see you be the best you can be. I want to see you be rebranded. I want to see you win in every area of your life. And if you're tired, if you're exhausted, if physically you're going through all kinds of stuff, you're not going to be able to do everything that you want to do. You're not going to be able to follow through with all the purposes that God has for you. And I realize sometimes there's things that happen to us physically that we have no control over, right? That happens sometimes. But a lot of it, you do research and look at it. I mean, I've seen articles that say like up to 90% of the health issues that we have is self-inflicted. It's because of our lifestyle. It's because of the way we don't honor our bodies, right? We don't honor God with our bodies. And I care about you guys. I don't want to see you guys just surviving through life. I don't want to see you suffering. I don't want to see you in pain. I don't want to see you just like, let me just take another pill. Let me just try to just push through today. I want to see you guys not just survive. I want to see you thrive. We should be thriving as God's children. There's wisdom, there's information, there's all this right at our fingertips, but many times we don't have the discipline to do it. So we're going to do it together. We're going to do it together, y'all. We got to have a vision for our physical health. You got to have a vision for that. You have to have a plan. What does that look like today? So I want you to take inventory. And I know it's different for all of us because we're all different seasons of life. We all have different body types, all those different things. You might be a size medium jacket and you need to put some weight on to get to a large. You need to put some muscle on. You might be a 3X jacket and you need to downsize a little bit to a 2X or just a 1X. Right? So whatever your case is, like, we're all in different places, right? But we got to take inventory. We got to come up, like, what is the vision for you in this season that God has for you to get healthier? You got to be honest. So we're going to look at a couple categories today, and we got to be real today. And I want you to take some notes on, like, man, this is some things I need to change maybe in this category. Okay, so here's the first one I want to ask. I want to ask you some questions. Number one is what are you eating? What does your diet look like? This is what the average American diet looks like. It looks like this. I know some of you are starting to like salivate right now. You're like, oh, lunch. Pastor Tommy, you're making me hungry. Oh. But the average American diet is full of fatty foods that are fried, that are double fried and dipped and all kinds of stuff, right? There's lots of calories. It's highly processed, right? That's the average American diet. And you know what? You could get away with it when you're young. All y'all young people in the crowd, like, oh, I'm fine. Like, I ate a pizza at 3 a.m. I'm good, right? But how many of y'all know it starts to catch up with you? You get up in your 30s and your 40s and, like, you know, you don't have that six-pack anymore. And you just, man, you, like, you're starting to feel it, right? And so I know y'all. Look at me. It is more expensive to eat healthy. It is. How many of y'all know that? Some of y'all are like, I just can't afford to get the organic stuff. I can't afford to go to that, you know, that lunch place. I'm just going to get a burger for 99 cents. I can't afford to go there. It's $14 for lunch. Listen, it might be a little more expensive now, but if you eat the bad stuff, the cheap stuff, stuff that tastes good too, right? But if you eat just all that stuff, it's going to catch up with you. It's going to be way more expensive in the long run. And your quality of life is going to be affected and impacted as time goes on as well. And so you got to train your palate to eat healthier. I know that stuff tastes good. I like it too. But you got to train your palate to eat some healthy things, right? I first started eating salad when I was like 19, 20 years old. I never had a salad before that. I thought that was for old people. But I started to like train myself and I tried to like, man, I got to eat more greens. I got to mix it up. I can't keep eating all this stuff, right? But as you train your palate, there's a lot of things that I really like now that I didn't like before. Even like avocados. The first time I had an avocado, I was like, you know, I shared that story, I think like about a year ago. My father-in-law, Papi, he was like cutting avocados up at breakfast. Hey, you want some? And he's like, they're good, you know. And I took one. I was like, he's like, you want another one? I'm like, no, I'm good. Trying to swallow it, right? But now I love avocados. I eat them regularly, put them on all kinds of stuff. It's like a superfood, right? So if you need some direction for like a balanced, healthy diet. We're going to put some stuff on our Church Fit Facebook group this month. We're going to give you some different options. There's going to be all kinds of information and stuff that we're going to be giving you guys this month. So we encourage you guys, tap in. But you got to take inventory. What are you eating? What are you putting in? Y'all know the old saying, garbage in, right? You know, I'm not even going to go there, right? So second thing to ask, what are you drinking? What are you drinking? Because a lot of y'all are drinking this stuff right here, like all day, every day. You're drinking it like it's going out of style. Y'all buying 24 packs and 32 packs. It was on sale, Pastor T. They had a great sale on it. Like, you know, and you're just like drinking all these sugary drinks. And yeah, it can like wake you up and give you some energy and some caffeine. But then later you crash and all that sugar is affecting your blood sugar and just a lot of other things in your system. And where's all my Hispanics at? All my Hispanics in the house, make some noise. Okay, so I'm gonna pick on y'all for a minute because y'all are drinking this. Y'all drinking them sodas. Oh yeah. That Coco Rico. Oh man, I love some Coco Rico. But see, the problem with this, if you don't know about these sodas, everybody else that's in the room, let me tell you something. So a regular can of soda might have 30 to 35 grams of sugar. These got 65 to 70 grams in one can. I mean, it's like drinking two cans of soda in one. It is like all sugar. That's why, like, so many Hispanics get diabetes by age 40, right? It's because of that. I think it's a conspiracy right there. It's up there, right? And so, listen, I know a lot of different people. I cut soda out of my diet many years ago. I'm water. I might drink soda, like, a couple times a year on a special occasion. I have a small little bit of it, treat myself, right? You could do things in small moderation at times, right? But I just, generally, I drink water all the time. And I just, man, it cleans you out. It's good for you. It hydrates you. It's good. Spring water, especially. Purified water sometimes takes some of the minerals out. You study on water. There's better kinds of waters as well. Hydrogen water is good for you. I'm about to get into that. But listen, what you hydrate your body with, it's important. It counts. I know people that stopped drinking soda, and they didn't start exercising. They didn't do anything else. And within a month or two, they lost 15, 20 pounds just because they stopped drinking soda. I mean, they drank soda at every meal, breakfast, lunch, dinner. I know people that wake up in the morning, instead of a coffee, they have a Pepsi. I'm like, man, that's crazy. Second part of what are you drinking? And I'm going to go there, y'all. How much alcohol are you drinking? Oh, yeah. Yep, we're going to talk about that at church. Now, listen, the Bible doesn't say that having alcohol is a sin. It doesn't. If you have a glass of wine or just a little bit of something, can't have a little bit of some of that too much, though. It'll, like, get you real quick, right? But the Bible makes it very clear that when you get drunk, when you leave a sober mind, that becomes a sin. And if you're in here and you've been drunk before, you know, or if you know people that have been drunk, you know that they say some things and do some things that they later regret, right? How many of y'all ever been there? You don't have to raise your hand. I'm just kidding. We're not doing confession this morning. It's all right. It's all right. But second of all, drinking a lot of alcohol can be destructive to your health. It is not good for you. And yet we got liquor stores on every corner in the hood. See how they set everything up? You got the check cashing place and the cash advance place. And you got the liquor store. That's how you know you're in a low-income neighborhood. And they prey on people that are in pain. I'm in pain, let me go drink something to make myself feel better. I'm out of money, let me get a payday advance with like 30% interest on it. And so I'm never going to end up paying it back. And I'm in slavery now, you know, financially. And I'm in slavery now because I'm getting addicted to drinking this alcohol, right? And that's why you see so many health problems in so many families, because they're putting in the wrong stuff and they get caught in a cycle. And I know all of us have stories in this room of probably people in our family that got caught up in alcoholism. Some of you that are here, you struggle with that. It's a real thing, y'all. My father-in-law, he passed away from cirrhosis of the liver over 10 years ago. Died young. He was only in his 60s. He should have had a lot more years. He was healthy other than that. And you know what? He stopped drinking like decades and decades ago. and he loved Jesus. He hadn't touched any alcohol, but because he drank a lot when he was younger, he was a heavy drinker, it still had consequences. Catches up with you. I had another friend in 1996, back in the day, that he went out and got drunk, and when he was out drinking, he lost his balance, and he fell and hit his head on the corner of a curb and died because he was drunk. And so I've been impacted, and I've had people around me been super impacted because of alcoholism and people just drinking too much. And so I want to ask you today, like, what are you drinking? Because you can eat clean and do all the other stuff right, but if you're still drinking a lot regularly, it's going to catch up with you. It's going to catch up with you. Take inventory. If you want to have a vision for your physical health, there's some things you might have to cut out, y'all. I'm telling you this because I love you. We're going to go deeper now. Third question, what are you smoking? Oh, yeah. We're going to talk about it today. We're going to talk about it today, y'all. Yeah. Because some of y'all, I walk into your spot and it's like this. So I know that smoking cigarettes is not as popular as it used to be. You watch those TV shows from back in the day, and like everybody was just smoking like crazy. They're smoking in the house, smoking in the restaurant. It was like everywhere, right? Like now it's like, oh my gosh, right? So smoking, they've had all these campaigns and all this stuff. But now, like in the middle of all that, something else is like snuck right in and like, whoo, vaping. It's safer. Is it? I don't know. Like there's a lot of different research out there about it right now, and you know, it's full of addictive chemicals that sometimes can be even more dangerous than traditional cigarettes sometimes, and we don't even know the long-term effects because it's still so new. Bottom line is our lungs are not meant for smoke to go in there all the time, or heavy vapor or whatever or chemicals. Like our lungs are not made for that. They're not. So let's talk about the elephant in the room. Because some of y'all smelled it when you walked in, maybe. I don't know. Weed. Oh, yeah, we smell you when you come in to our church. We do. We love you. We love you, and we're glad you're here. And you know we're a church that welcomes everybody when you get some smells like that at Crossover. Because just come on. We love you. Come on in. Come on in. But let's talk about that for a second. Yeah, it's recreationally, it's not legal here in Florida. It is in a lot of the states now, and that's being pushed more and more. But if you have a headache or a little bit of back pain, or you just say that you do, you could go get yourself a card now, and you could get whatever you need, right? That's the world that we live in now. Yes, I know for some people, man, it can really help them with pain. I acknowledge that. But a lot of people, they're not doing it for pain. They're doing it to get high. You're doing it to escape from your regular reality. Some people will say, well, it helps me with my anxiety. But I talk to a lot of people that are like, man, I had to stop doing it because it was giving me anxiety, right? So, but either way, it's not natural for your lungs. It's not. We're not meant to, like, smoke stuff. That's not the way that God designed our bodies. It's not, over time, it's not great for our brain cells. There's a lot of different effects that happen over time. Plus, I know a lot of people that smoke regularly, and they'll say, man, yeah, it relaxes me, but it makes me lazy. It makes me unmotivated, and it makes me just want to sit and vegetate on the couch and play video games and just have the munchies, right? It got real quiet now. It got real quiet. It was a little loud at first. Now people are like, you know. So I just want to tell you today, as your pastor, I love you. I care about you. I want you to be careful what you're smoking. Because for some of you in here, it's holding you back in some ways. And it's a crutch. It's a crutch that you've allowed to come into your life. And you know it. But because it's so normalized and popular, you're like, well, everybody's doing it. And, you know, I smell it everywhere. And, you know, it's available now. And, you know, but I want to ask you, is it really good for what God has called you to do? You got to take inventory if you want to get fit. We're going to talk about every area. Number four, we're going to keep going, y'all. Y'all ready? Some of y'all ready to leave now. You're like, man, I knew I shouldn't have came to church today. It was raining and everything. And, man, Pastor T raining on my parade. Number four, what pills are you taking? What pills are you taking? Now, first off, let me frame it like this. Medicine can be a blessing. Thank God for medicine. Thank God for advancements in medicine. I'm not saying to stop taking your medicine at all. Thank God for it. But I believe our country as a whole, a lot of people in our country have abused and set up a system to keep people medicated and not treat a problem, but just treat a symptom and keep you on the medication because there's a lot of profit and there's a lot of money involved. And now profit is over people, right? How many of y'all have seen that that documentary on Netflix, that show, Painkillers? Anybody seen that? And there's a couple of them out there. I've watched like two of them. That gives you a little glimpse of what happens sometimes in the world of pharmaceuticals and all that stuff that's going on. And so the original doctor I went to when she gave me some medication for my thyroid, she said, well, you're just going to have to take this for the rest of your life. You're getting a little older now, and it is what it is. And the Holy Spirit put him in my heart, nah, don't accept that. I'm serious, I felt that. And I don't always like walk around saying like God told me, but I just felt in my spirit again and again like, nah, that's not going to be your story. You need to research. You need to do some work. You need to get it in and figure this out. I can heal you if you work on this, right? And so I'm so grateful for my doctor. She does regular medicine as well, but she does holistic medicine. And holistic medicine focuses on trying to heal the actual issue, not cover up the symptoms with pharmaceuticals. And you know what, for me, y'all, that resonates so much because that's our mission at Crossover Church. We're not here to just treat your symptoms. We want to help you get to the root of the issue that's going on and apply Jesus to it and then watch real healing happen so you can be whole and made healed. That's why that resonates with me, right? Because some of you, like in this world that we're in, you just want to come in and get a quick fix. Let me come into worship and just, I feel better. Oh, man, I felt better. I feel good now. And then you leave, and that covered up some of the symptoms for a few hours or a few days. But then you leave, and you go directly back to the problem and reindulge in it again, and it's still happening. And you're still depressed, and you're still anxious, and you still got all these issues and problems and addictions. And then you come back next Sunday for another little hit again so you can feel good. And listen, we don't want to just treat your symptoms. We want to get to the root of the issue. And that's what Jesus does. That's what the gospel does when you really apply it, y'all. But you got to apply it. You got to live this out. You got to take some challenges. It's hard to do some of these things because it's not normal, y'all. But we want to see you guys get healthier in every area, whether you're 22, 42, 72. God created our bodies to heal themselves. And I know that's not the situation for everybody. You might have something that you can't like heal yourself. You have to get all kinds of things done, right? But a lot of the issues we have, a lot of diseases can be healed if we just make some changes. If we get discipline, if we got a vision, if we take responsibility. I know so many people that have gotten off medication because they just changed their lifestyle and they got healthy. And a lot of times they're not going to encourage you to do those things and tell you how to do those things. Just take the medication. And as time goes on, oh, now you got to take this other one. And then there's a side effect of that one, so you got to take this one. And it just can stack up. And I know people that are on like 10, 12 different medications, and it's crazy. And as time goes on, that wears on your liver, your kidneys, your body in so many different ways, y'all. And so, but I'm telling you, God can heal. God's a healer. We sang about it today. He's a healer. Nothing's impossible for God. I might get canceled for some of this stuff that I'm saying, but I don't care. Listen, number five, y'all, are you resting? Are you resting? I'm going to spend a whole Sunday talking about this later this month in this series, but rest is so important. I'm not going to talk about it too much right now, but you got to take inventory. How much are you resting? Some of you are like your cell phone. You only plug in for a few hours to rest. And so then the next day you walking around on 5% in the red. The whole time. Yeah, y'all know some of y'all got your phones like that, right? That's some of your bodies. You're always in the red. You're always this exhausted and tired because you're not resting enough. We're going to talk about that. We're going to get into that. Number six. This is the one you're really going to love me on, some of y'all. Are you exercising? Are you exercising? I know some of y'all are going to roll your eyes like, well, I'm a skinny guy up there telling me to exercise. Man, it's not hard for him. Listen, I know it takes discipline. It's hard. I was the opposite. I had to put weight on. You know, I put on, in the last 15 years, I put on 25 pounds. I was 25 pounds skinnier than this, but I put on 25 pounds in the right places, but it took work. It was hard. I was in the gym last night because I'm going to practice what I preach, y'all. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 11, it talks about discipline. It says this. It says, no discipline is enjoyable while it's happening. It's painful. It's painful. But afterwards, there will be a peaceful harvest of right living for those who are trained in this way. Listen, when you train yourself, when you rebrand yourself to live right, spiritually, to live right, physically, when you honor God with your body because it's not your what? Not your own. When you've got a vision for your physical health, you can begin to find that perfect fit. Let me tell you, it's peaceful. Feels good. It's a great quality of life. You feel so much better. You can think better, more clearer. You got energy. You're more productive. Does that sound good to anybody? You want to be all those things? Like, yeah, like, this is what it takes. And I'm not going to lie. I know it's hard in the culture that we live in with all the bad food that tastes good. And it's cheaper. And we got screens that we can just stare at for 10 hours a day. But get away from your screen and get out. Get your muscles in motion. Go for a walk. Go for a bike ride. Go to the gym. Go do something. Do some push-ups. Do some jumping jacks or something. Like, just like, get your muscles moving, y'all. Look at somebody and tell them, move. You got to move. Type that in the chat, move. You got to move. So at Crossover this year, we are rebranding, and it's going to take some work. So take inventory of what we did so far this year. We had 21 days of prayer and fasting, right? So a lot of y'all were part of that. That drew us closer to God, you know, revealed some new things, right? Then last week we talked about, let's get our finances right. You're going to get your finances right. You got to put God first. So we started officially this month our 90-day tithe challenge. You can still jump in on that. Say, hey, God, I'm going to give you my first and best, 10%. You're going to take that 90%. You're going to breathe on it. You're going to bless it. You're going to do miracles. We had a bunch of people jump in. You could still jump in, be part of that. It's on the app. It's on the website. You could jump in. Fire starters. We have 181 families now that have become fire starters. Let's go. That's amazing. Like, so God is like rebranding us in all these different areas, like financially and getting closer to God and habits and all these things. But we got to do some stuff physically, y'all. We are going to become a fit church. Every month this year, we're going to have some different physical challenges that we're going to put out there and we're going to talk about. And so February is actually, it's National Heart Month, and it's about your heart. So we're going to do this challenge. If you could pop it up on the screen, this is our challenge for the month of February. So pop that up there, and this is what we are doing this month. So we are doing a steps challenge for my heart. It's going to start tomorrow, February 5th. It's going to go till March 5th. There's a QR code right there you can tap into as well. And so here's what it is. We know there's different levels. Everybody's not on the same level. We get that totally. So if you're in the beginner category, you're going to do 5,000 steps per day. So that adds up to, what, 150,000 steps for the month, right? So you're going to be logging that in, right? So you can join our Facebook page for Fit Church. We're going to give you guys some information on how to get that as well. Tap in. You can log that in weekly there. Be accountable. Maybe you're in the intermediate zone. You're going to do 10,000 steps per day. Anybody do 10,000 steps a day? Any of y'all? Some of y'all are steppers. You know about it, right? So that'll add up to, you do the math on that, that's 300,000 steps that you're going to do for the month. So if you know, so some days if you only do like 8,000, then the next day you're going to do 12,000, right? You're going to catch up to get that to that total. But some of y'all are advanced. Some people are 15,000 steps per day. Some of y'all are getting it in. You want to be in that one. That's 450,000 steps that month. But I want to encourage you guys, like, at least start with that. That's easy. Go take a walk. Get some steps in. Get your muscles moving. And guess what? We got some prizes, too. We're going to have prizes every month. We're going to have prizes. We got gift cards for you. So there's going to be some gift cards given out, like, and they start at $100. So jump in. For each category, there is going to be some different gift cards and prizes that we're going to give out. You can sign up on the register page to be part of the challenge, and that's going to give you all the information of how to tap in and be accountable and get it in. We're going to become a fit church in 2024 in every way, physically, financially, spiritually, emotionally. And if you're with me today, come on, make some noise. Come on, Crossover, you with me? Yeah. So if you're here today and you would say, yeah, Pastor T, I'm going to work on my health this year. I want to get more fit. I want to get better. I want you to stand. I want to pray for you today if that's you. If you're in, say, yup, I'm going to get healthier in 2024. I want to invite you to stand with me. If you're at home worshiping online, I want to invite you to stand up too, because we're talking about getting fit and some of y'all are sitting on the couch this whole time. Like, stand up at home as well. If you're in your car, stay seated. So I want you to just, as a sign of surrender, I want you to just put your hands up to God, because we need his help in this area. It's hard. It's challenging at times. There's so much temptation left and right. Let's put our hands up to God. Let me pray for you today. Father, we come before you today. Our hands are lifted to heaven. And again, first of all, God, we say we're sorry for the times that we haven't honored you with our body and when we've been maybe lazy with our diet, with our exercise, with things that we've done to our body that have not attributed to good health. But God, our hands are up to you today in a sign of surrender, saying, God, we need your help. Help us, Father God, as we take this journey together to become more fit. God, I pray for those that are in this room and in rooms all over right now that need physical healing. They've got ailments. They've got things going on. Some of it might just be genetic from their family. Some of it might just be lifestyle stuff that they've done. Whatever the case is, God, I pray that supernaturally you'll begin to touch their body and bring healing. But I pray in the natural, God, that all of us will do the work. We'll do the things that we need to do to honor you. And we realize and we acknowledge today that our bodies are not our own. We have a relationship with you. You bought us with a high price, and we thank you for Jesus today. And if there's anybody here that doesn't have a relationship with Jesus, today could be the day you could start that. Right here, right now, just simply call out to God and say, I believe, forgive me. I want to follow you. God will become to come in your life and change you and make you fit in every single area. And so, God, I pray for blessings upon each person and their family. God, give us discipline when the temptation pops up to eat something we shouldn't or do something we shouldn't. God, I pray you'll just give us strength and courage to say no, to put the fork down, or not to buy it, or not to go in the refrigerator at 1 a.m., whatever the case is, God. God, help us to be accountable with other people, God. And God, we pray for health and healing and wholeness. We pray this in Jesus' name. Everyone said, amen. Amen. Come on, give it up for Jesus today, y'all. Yeah.
Good morning, Crossover. How's everyone doing today? We just have a couple of announcements for you guys. First and foremost, can we give it up for our first-time guests? Yes, make them feel welcome. So listen, if this is your first time here at Crossover Church, you are VIP. Yes, you're very important to us. Same to you online. This is your first time watching with us. You're VIP. What we want you to do, if this is your first time, there is a table right there in the lobby. We have a special gift for you. We just want to welcome you here to Crossover Church and also say thank you for coming to see us. And also online, if you go to crossoverchurch.org/I'm new, you will also get a free gift as well. Who's excited for First Wednesdays? Amen. So this Wednesday, February 7th, we will be having First Wednesdays. That is our growth night. Listen, you do not want to miss out on this. It's a great time to grow and learn, and it's going to be an amazing experience. If you haven't been to one, this is your time to go. How many of you have started the Leadership Lab? Y'all can be excited. Thank you. I appreciate that. Leadership Lab is fun, guys. Make it seem like it's homework. Well, it probably is homework, but that's just beside the point. So listen, Leadership Lab started yesterday, February 3rd. So I know some of you, it looks like some of you may have missed it. You still have 2 more weeks to sign up. So it is going to be every first Saturday of each month will be the Leadership Lab. And if you finish finish it all the way through December, you're going to graduate with a certificate to say, hey, I finished the leadership lab, and it's free. It's a great opportunity to grow as leaders in the church. So you have 2 more weeks to sign up. Somebody say 2 weeks. You have 2 more weeks to sign up. After that, it's going to be closed. Amen? All right. How many of us got phones? Yeah. Everybody got a phone in here. Y'all ain't got to act. So listen, you do have a phone. You ain't got to act like that. So listen, if you don't have the Crossover Church app, please download the Crossover Church app. That is a great opportunity for you to go on and see what we have going on. All the events, you can go to the register page for all of the events and you'll be able to see what we have going on. You can also go to the website, but I want everybody to download the app. It's part of one of our values. We download the apps. Amen. Are we? I can clap. Exactly. Amen. All right, if everyone will stand to your feet if you can, we would like to say our mission statements. They will be on all of the screens. And we'll say it on a count of three. 1, 2, 3. Our mission is to empower people to discover, develop, and display Jesus Christ in every area of our lives. You guys have an amazing Sunday. God bless you.
Jesus, me take up. How when me feel like me young up, break up. Put the blood on me face, just like my makeup. In the morning, when me wake up. And the blood of Jesus, me take up. How when me feel like me young up, break up. Put the blood on me face, just like my makeup. Under the blood. Under the blood. Jesus, cover me. Jesus, if it cover me. Say, under the blood, me say me on is the blood. Under the blood, me say me on is the blood. Jesus, cover me under the blood. Under the blood, me say me under the blood. In the morning, when me wake up, under the blood of Jesus. Me I'm gonna give blood.